Welcome to the our Bible study here on Maundy Thursday. It is the day in the church year where we look at what Christ has given us in the Lord's Supper, and it is really the kickoff to the end of Holy Week. At the end of this service, we strip our altar and prepare for Good Friday, because after Christ celebrates the Passover feast and gives us the Lord's Supper, he is arrested, and hopefully you know the rest of the story. If not, come to church on Good Friday and Easter. You'll hear it. As far as the text for today, which was last Sunday's epistle, I have chosen these two verses from Philippians 2, verses 10 and 11. That at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus is Christ, to the glory of the Father. As I was preparing for this little Bible study, I was trying to think of things that was universal, that all humans have experienced no matter what. And it's actually, if you sit there and ruminate on it, well, it's hard. I guess death and taxes is about as close as we're going to get. But there's another one on this list, and that is that all people will be in front of Jesus, the judge, when death comes. It is universal for everyone. And the shocking thing about it is that all people who go in front of Christ will do two things. They will kneel out of respect for being in the presence of God. And two, they will confess that Jesus is the Christ. Now, that does not mean that they are saved. It means that they're aware of who they're in front of. So in our text today, it says on earth, in heaven, and kind of poetically, under the earth. So maybe the most shocking thing is that everyone in hell is very much aware of who Jesus is, and that he is the Christ, and that they had in their life rejected him, and they have been judged. And unlike everyone in our prison system in the United States today, everyone in hell is in fact aware that they are rightfully where they belong, which is shocking. What maybe is even more shocking is the people in heaven. You see, we live in a very strange culture today where we get confused. The question our culture asks is, how can God send anyone to hell, especially good people? But that's not the question the Bible is answering. It's not the question people thought about in Jesus' day, Martin Luther's day, or even Moses' day. Their question is, how could God let anyone into heaven? And in that, we do have an answer. It is Christ. I saw a t-shirt once with, it said this. It said, you all act like Jesus don't care anymore. Or to translate into Pittsburgh, yins act like Jesus don't care no more. He does. And that no matter what happens in this life, universally speaking, all will go in front of Christ. And all will say, that is the Christ. And what was most shocking is not that hell is full. What is most shocking is heaven is full. For that is something that we do not deserve, that God has given us as a gift through his son, our Lord Jesus. A little humility, maybe. Our society lacks it. We are almost demanding of everything at this point. We're demanding of good service. We're demanding that we're going to be treated right. We're demanded that we will never be offended again. We're demanded that life is easy. We're demanded that we should not suffer. We demand everything in this world right now. We are teenagers, and we go to God, and instead of on our knees humbly begging and asking for forgiveness, we go to him and demand salvation, even if I want nothing to do with Christ. Not how it works. The Christian heart is always filled with joy because the slot that we have in heaven, the spot written in the book of life with our name, is a gift that we do not deserve. And so we go to the throne of Christ humbly, and we drop to our knees joyfully, and we confess then, as we have in our life, that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, our Savior. Let us pray. Dear Lord, watch over us and keep us safe during this pandemic. Prepare our hearts for this Holy Week. Show us the glory of the Lord's Supper as we go to church and enjoy the Lord's Supper and Maundy Thursday services. Dear Lord, watch over us and bring joy to our hearts as the resurrection of our Lord Sunday is coming up. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.